गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वांट टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ईयर. ईयर इज अ स्टैको अकस्टिक ऑर्गन. स्टैको अकस्टिक ऑर्गन meant for two functions. It is useful for two functions. One function is auditory in function, hearing. One function is auditory in function, hearing. And another one is equilibrium. Another one is the equilibrium. It will be as balance of an organism. Again, I recap. Which organ is said to be as the stacho acoustic organ? Ear. What are the functions of ear? Auditory and balance. These ear divided into three important parts. They are outer ear, middle ear, inner ear or labyrinth. So what I wrote on the blackboard is the total ear is differentiated into three kinds: outer ear and middle ear and inner ear. So there are a pair of eyes you observed here. These are the outer ear. They call it as outer ear parts. They called pinna. First one is outer ear. Outer ear including ear pinna or auricles. Ear pinna or auricles. There is a pair of eyes. Observe here, there is a pair of auricles, the ear pinna, which are made up of the cartilage is elastic cartilage. They're made up of the cartilage is elastic cartilage covered with skin. It is covered with skin. It is receives vibrations and they send sound signals into the median part of the ear. So this is a pinna. Pinna to that, next to go for the part is called auditory meatus. This is the auditory meatus. Here go up to the deeper, there is the auditory meatus. This has to be as oblique auditory meatus or oblique auditory canal. It is having this pinna is having hair like some hairs, and here some hairs are present on auditory meatus, and there is the glands. That glands are called as the ceruminous glands, which are producing cerumen. Whenever the pathogens or dust particles are entered, these cerumen or wax, that is said to be as the cerumen, that cerumen or wax, which is trap it and send it out. I recap. There is a pair of ear pinnas. Then go for a medially, obliquely, there is a canal-like structure is there. That is called oblique auditory canal. It is having waxy glands which produces a cerumen, which are trapping the pathogens which are sending out. This oblique auditory meatus is ends as the structure is called eardrum. So here, this is the eardrum. This eardrum is having lateral and median surfaces. It is having two surfaces. This is the lateral surface, this is the median surface. Lateral surface is a skin fold. Lateral surface is a skin fold. Whereas the median surface, which is facing towards the middle ear, is a mucous surface or mucous membrane. Outer ear related to that points concerned, they having three important parts. They are a pair of ear pinnas, a pair of oblique auditory canals, eardrum. Eardrum is also called tympanum. This is the eardrum. This eardrum is having two faces. One is the lateral and another one is the median. Lateral side, there is the skin surface, whereas the median side, there is mucous surface is there. This is eardrum. Eardrum is also called tympanum. The first tympanum is appeared in amphibians. For neat concern, first tympanum is appeared in amphibians. Then go for middle ear. Know that this is a ear pinna, this is a oblique auditory canal, this is the tympanum. These middle ear containing ear ossicles and eustachian tube. They containing ear ossicles and eustachian tube. Eustachian tube. Total number of ear ossicles in our body are this side 3 and this side 3. Total 6 ear ossicles are there. They are arranged in a chain-like fashion. These ear ossicles are arranged chain-like fashion. They are arranged in a chain-like fashion. They are said to be as, one is the malleus. Another one is that incus, and another one is stapes. These bones arranged in a chain-like fashion, very close to that eardrum. This is ear ossicle which is very close to that eardrum. That ear ossicle is a malleus. It is a look like hammer shape. That is look like hammer shape. So for that is the hammer shaped bone. The shape of this bone is said to be as hammer shape. This is the intermediate bone which is connecting malleus and stapes. This is the incus. Incus, shape of the incus is a anvil shape. This is the incus. Incus shape is anvil. Anvil. It is anvil shape. Anvil shape. It is intermediate ear ossicle between malleus and stapes. Stapes is a third bone here, third ear ossicle. These stapes is look like stirrup shaped bone. That is look like stirrup. That is look like stirrup shape. So there are the three shapes. One is the hammer shaped. Second one is anvil shaped, which is used in gold industry. That anvils are used in gold. That is anvil shaped things, objects are used for hammering the gold. Anvil shaped. This is a stirrup shaped bone. Criminals or the policemen who tie up that this type of things. That criminals, the policemen who used for criminals, this type of things are used. They are seen the, that is the town services which are hanged there. We want to catch it while to doing the traveling. Again, I am saying there are the three shaped bones. Three bones are there. They are malleus, incus, stapes. Malleus is the hammer shaped. Incus is the anvil shaped. Stapes is the hammer shaped. That is the stirrup shaped. These bones are arranged in a chain-like fashion. This is attached to eardrum. This is attached to oval. This is attached to oval window. This middle ear is a air-filled cavity. This is a air-filled cavity. So concerned for middle ear. Need concern. How many ear ossicles are there? 3 ear ossicles. Arrange the following sequentially the ear ossicles from lateral side to that median side. Malleus, incus, stapes. Shape of the malleus is hammer shape. Shape of the incus is anvil shape. Shape of the stapes is a stirrup shaped. Name the ear ossicle which is connected to the oval window of cochlea. Stapes. Name the ear ossicle which is connecting the eardrum. Malleus. Then there is a tube-like structure called the Eustachian tube, which is also the part of it. There is the Eustachian tube. It is the part of it. There is the Eustachian tube. Here, this is the nasopharynx. This is the nasopharynx. Here, in digestive tract concerned, this is the esophagus, this is the stomach, here this is the pharynx. There is a middle ear part which connecting like this. Eustachian tube is the part of middle ear which connecting middle ear to nasopharynx, middle ear to nasopharynx. What is the use of this one is they get be equalize the sound vibrations on either side of the eardrum. What is the use of it is it equalizes the sound vibrations on either side of eardrum. Next go for very very important area of the ear concerned is inner ear. Again I am go for recap. There is a very special sense organ for auditory and equilibrium or static function is ear. Ear is having outer ear, middle ear, inner ear. Outer ear containing a pair of auricles, a pair of oblique auditory canals and eardrum or tympanum. Ear ossicles are made of elastic cartilage that is covered with skin having hair, which is the first part which takes vibrations and convert into sound waves. They send into median side of the ear. Oblique auditory canal is also having hairs. They having waxy glands which are producing wax substance that serve as a cerumen. They engulf the pathogens to send out. Eardrum is the first structure appeared in the amphibians. Eardrum is also called tympanum. This having two sides. One is the median side, lateral side and median side. Lateral side is a skin surface, whereas median side is the mucous surface. Go for the next part is called middle ear. Eardrum is a partition between outer ear and middle ear. Middle ear is air-filled cavity. It is having Eustachian tube and ear ossicles. Eustachian tube which connecting middle ear to nasopharynx that is equalize the sound vibrations on either side of the eardrum. There is 3 ear ossicles on one side and 3 ear ossicles on another side arranged in chain-like fashion and they useful for taking the sound vibrations and their intensity get be increases here. They are malleus, incus and stapes. Malleus is touches to the eardrum on one side and on the other side that touches to the stapes. This is a hammer shaped bone. Intermediate bone is incus or anvil shaped bone. And the third bone is the stirrup shaped bone called stapes. That is attached to the oval window of cochlea. Then go for inner ear or labyrinth. Go for inner ear or labyrinth. inner ear or a labyrinth. This inner ear comprises very very important parts like cochlea and semicircular canals and vestibular, that is ovotelith organs. These two are collectively called as vestibular apparatus. Part of the blackboard is, there is the cochlea, there is the semicircular canals, three one side and three another side. There is the three semicircular canals at one side, means there is the three semicirculars on another side, and ovotelith organs. Semicircular canal and ovotelith organs are collectively called as vestibular apparatus. So you know that this is I go for the explanation of inner ear concern. Here there is a bony labyrinth and membranous labyrinth is the common architecture of the ear concern. In ear, there is a bony labyrinth and membranous labyrinth are seen. Throughout the inner ear, there is a bony and membranous labyrinths are seen. So go for the semicircular canals. The gopher semicircular canals and cochlea. Semicircular canals, cochleas, and here on diagram I draw the cochlea, the vestibular region and the semicircular regions, bony structure I draw. This is the semicircular canal, this is the vestibule, this is the cochlea. The gopher membranous labyrinth concerned, I am using one more color. Membranous labyrinth, this is the total membranous labyrinth. This is called cochlear duct. This is the cochlea. This is the cochlear duct. This is the cochlea. Cochlea is a bony labyrinth. Cochlear duct is the membranous labyrinth. Cochlear duct is the membranous labyrinth. Then go over vestibular region. This is the vestibule. This region is the vestibule region. I am using one more color. Vestibule is the bony labyrinth, so made up of bone, and there is a membranous labyrinth. There is a membranous labyrinth. There is a membranous labyrinth. It is said to be as a saccule and utricle. Saccule and utricle. Bony part is called cochlea. Membranous part is called cochlear duct. Bony part is called vestibule. Membranous part is a saccule and utricle. Here semicircular canals are the bony part. Semicircular canal ducts are called it as a membranous labyrinth. I am using one more color. This is the membranous labyrinth. This is the membranous labyrinth. This is that membranous labyrinth. the membranous labyrinth. Membranous labyrinth of semicircular canals are called semicircular canal ducts. Membranous labyrinth of the vestibular operator called utricle and saccule. Membranous labyrinth of the cochlea is called cochlear duct. This is the cochlea. Cochlea is mainly useful for hearing function. Very, very important area for hearing function. You observed this is the zone. And you observed this is the another zone. This is another. Three differentiate portions are there. Here also observed this is one portion. This is the another portion. This is the another portion. Here observed this is the one portion. This is the another portion. This is the another portion. This portion is said to be as scala tympanum. This is the scala tympanum. This is the scala media. This is the scala vestibuli. Cochlea is having three portions. They are scala, this is the scala vestibuli, this is the scala media, this is the scala tympanum. Here there is the fluid. That fluid is a perilymph. This fluid is said to be as perilymph. That fluid present at a scala tympanum and scala vestibuli is a perilymph. It is a perilymph. Somewhat chemically, that is differ with endolymph with respect to the ions concerned. Here there is a cochlea. This is a cochlear. This is that cochlea. This is the cochlear duct, membranous. Within the cochlear duct, there is the fluid. That fluid is said to be as a endolymph. This is the endolymph. Black color dot I am using here. This is the endolymph. Where I used black color, there is the endolymph. I am using black color, there is a endolymph is there. Here there is the endolymph. Where I am using blue color, there is a perilymph is there. Here there is a perilymph. Again, I go for cochlea. Cochlea is a bony part. Cochlear duct is a membranous part. There is three zones are there. Scala vestibuli, scala media, scala tympanum. Scala vestibuli, scala tympanum. There is a fluid called perilymph. Scala media, so the cochlear duct at which endolymph is there. Endolymph is chemically not, is differ with perilymph. Then membrane here, this membranous fold is greatly modified. This greatly modified area is said to be as a Reisner's membrane. This greatly modified area is said to be as a basilar membrane. This membrane is a Reisner's membrane. This membrane is said to be as basilar membrane. A membrane which divides scala vestibuli to scala media. Reisner's membrane. A membrane which is present between scala vestibuli to scala media is a basilar membrane. Scala tympanum to scala media. This membrane is basilar membrane. on basilar membrane there is greatly modified organ of Corti is there. Here there is a greatly modified organ of Corti in this area. I am using black color. There is a some hair cells are there, hair cells. Here there is a some hair cells are there. These are the hair cells. Then there is a membrane which is a cover over here is called a tectorial membrane. A membrane which is cover over here called tectorial membrane. Here there is the neurons. There are the neurons. There is the neurons. There is the neurons. You observe here, there are the neurons. That neurons are carrying auditory signals from cochlea to cerebral cortex of the brain. Cerebral cortex of the brain. This region is said to be as organ of Corti. This region is said to be as organ of Corti. So this is the cochlear duct. Here organ of Corti is there. These are hair-like cells. They are having stereocilias and kinetocilias. There is a, they are, this membrane is said to be as a basilar membrane, and this membrane is the tectorial membrane. This membrane is said to be as the tectorial membrane. This membrane is a basilar membrane. This entire structure is said to be as organ of Corti. Organ of Corti. And there is a number of nerve cells are there. They are useful for taking signals, auditory signals from cochlea to sending signals to that cerebral cortex of the brain. They send signals to cerebral cortex of the brain. And I recap about that cochlea. Cochlea is the part of inner ear. It is having outer bony labyrinth, back black colored, inner membranous labyrinth. Bony labyrinth is the called cochlea. Membranous labyrinth is said to be as cochlear duct. There is the three zones are seen here. They are scala vestibuli, scala media, scala tympanum. Scala vestibuli is attached to the oval window. Here where is the, this scala tympanum is attached at fenestra roundalis. That is a, this is at a oval round window. This is at a oval window. This is at a round window finishing. There is a perilymph is there in a scala vestibuli and scala tympanum. There is a membrane which divides these two is said to be as Raisner's membrane. A membrane which divides these two is called basilar membrane. There is a membrane which is called tectorial membrane. There is a tectorial membrane, modified membrane, which is covers over the apical apertures of the hair cell. Hair cells are having stereocilia and kinetocilias. Whenever the tectorial membrane pressed over there, action potentials are generated over the hair cell, and that is taken by the nerves, which are afferent nerves, which are attached, which are made synapse with hair cells, they taking appropriate signals to that cerebral cortex of the brain. Then go for ovotelith organs. Ovotelith organs are including, this is a bony part, vestibule, and membranous part called saccule and utricle. This fluid is continuous. Here, what is the fluid is present here, that is go for continuous. These utricles and saccule are arranged right angle with each other. They arranged right angle with each other. Observed, one is present here means another one is present here. They located right angle with each other. Very close to that cochlea is a saccule. Very close to that semicircular canal is utricle. Here, within the utricle and saccule, this is the membrane. This membrane is greatly modified and having some black colored cells are called maculae. This is the ridge of utriculus and saccules. A ridge of cochlea is organ of Corti. A ridge of utriculus and saccules are macula. The term macula, which means black. And there is a nerve cells are there. They having two processes. One is towards the hair cells. Another one is towards the brain. Here, related to that balance concern, the action potentials which are generated over the macula of otolith organs, sending signals to the afferent artery, that signals are traveled to the cerebral cortex of the brain. Then go for the semicircular canal. You observed this basal portion is becomes swollen. Basal portion is becomes swollen. This swollen portion is called ampulla. This is the ampulla. This is the bony part. Within the bony part, there is a membranous part is there. This is a semicircular duct. Semicircular duct is having endolymph. This is having perilymph and this is having perilymph. Here, this membranous structure is greatly modified and forms one more ridge-like structure is called ampulla. That is said to be as crista ampullaris. This is the crista. This is said to be as crista ampullaris. These cells are said to be as hair-like cells. These cells are hair-like cells. They taking any action potentials related to the static nature or kinetic nature, they taking that signals are taking by the neurons and sending signals to the cerebral cortex. They taking signals and they're sending to that information to that brain. They are also sending information to the brain. They are also sending information to the brain. This ridge is said to be as organ of Corti. This ridge is related to that utriculus and saccules is called macula. The ridge of semicircular canal said to be as crista ampullaris. So next to go for mechanism of hearing. Mechanism of hearing. Sound waves which are first received by the ear pinna to oblique auditory canal, oblique auditory canal to eardrum, eardrum to malleus, incus, stapes, oval window to cochlea. This is the membranous labyrinth, this is the bony labyrinth, this is the perilymph, this is the perilymph, perilymph to this is the basilar lamina, generate action potentials over the basilar membrane. Then this is the tectorial membrane. Here action potential generated over the hair like cilia, that is hair cells. Then the signals are taken by the nerve cells and is sending to the cerebral cortex related to the hearing concern. And I'm saying first sound vibrations are taken by the ear pinna to oblique auditory canal, eardrum or tympanum, malleus, incus, stapes, oval window, oval window to perilim, perilim to basilar membrane, then tectorial membrane, hair cells, hair cells to that afferent nerves, upper nerves to cerebral cortex of the brain. Very, very important for NEET. What is the sequential order, the taking of sound waves from ear pinna to cerebral cortex of the brain? I think this knowledge is more benefit to you for understanding the subject related to the NCERT. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. All the best, my dear students. All the best. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.